people in the kingdom come together for one common goal of winning souls to Christ and seeing the kingdom of God expanded. Come on, somebody. Some battles we're going to win as a team. Some battles we might lose, but we're going to look at how to defeat and get back on a winning streak. Sometimes somebody will have to sacrifice something in order for someone else to advance on their road with God. Are you a part of the team? We're going in. We're going to take this giant down. We're going to sacrifice what we got to sacrifice. We're going to trust God how we have to trust God. I'm going to believe we're going to deal with these giants, because I'm not going to let another 40 years pass and another generation go, oh, come on, somebody. I'm going to deal with this giant. We're going to get this building. We're going to get this land. We're going to get this provision. I'm going to get delivered from anger. I'm going to let go of my unforgiveness. I'm going to let go of my bitterness. I'm going to let go of all my hurt. I'm going to let go of all my past. I'm going to let go of all my issues. I'm going to let go of all things. I'm going to get rid of Egypt. I'm not going to play the victim. I'm not going to have resentment. I'm not going to play revenge. I'm not going to be mad at the world. I'm just going to go take care of these giants.
Wow, praise God. Thank God for all that He's done. It's amazing that we're living in the days that we actually prayed for. From beginning, literally in our house as a Bible study, to now seeing what God is doing. This is not a move of man. This is a move of God.
That's right.
To see what's happened at our Fullerton campus, our Costa Mesa campus, and online, to seeing lives be changed forever, the literally thousands, that's not an overstatement, the thousands of people that have given their life to Jesus, to God be the glory. What do you think, honey?
Look what the Lord has done. I mean, in a nutshell, I don't think we could do anything in a nutshell, because it's just so grand, every single thing that God has been doing, from just the salvations, from how many people and resources that we provided to our community, people that drove from other cities to come to see what was happening at Freedom House, lives being changed, families being restored, people that wanted to take their lives ended up not taking their lives because they found the hope of Jesus. I mean, the list goes on and on. Look what the Lord has done, and not just in our community, not just in our surroundings, but, you know, let's take a personal reflection right now. Look what the Lord has done in our personal lives, in our own homes, in our own families. My children are loving church, loving Jesus. I know that there's a revival in my home, and I know it's happening in yours as well. Look what God has done and what He continues to do.
Amen. The impossible has truly become possible with only God. When I think about our Fullerton campus and just how this was once just an empty building, has now grown through our 9:30, 11:30, our 5 p.m., our Wednesday, our kids are worshiping God, our Bible college is thriving, our growth track is full, the parking lot is people coming to church, and then at our Costa Mesa campus, where there wasn't a church, now there is a thriving church. We started that campus, and now hundreds of people are gathering and worshiping God. In fact, I had one person tell me how their life has been forever changed because of Costa Mesa. Now they have a place to call home. And then our online campus, we launched, and now we're reaching people literally across America and around the world that call Freedom House Church their home. And during the pandemic, they were able to get ministered to right in their home and commit their lives to Christ. We are truly changing our world one life at a time. To God be the glory. And I want you to hear from our campus pastors as well as our outreach director of all that we've been doing through our student ministry, outreach, and also at our campuses.
Hey, Freedom House, how's it going? It's Pastor Louie, the Fullerton campus pastor, and I'm so excited about what God is doing at Freedom House Church. Since last year, since the pandemic hit, it's caused us to do church in a very creative way, with creative ways on how to reach people. From our community outreach events to our online broadcasts, we reached so many people, and we saw the impact reflected when people started coming back to church from our outdoor services to having services inside. New people, new faces, new salvations, rebuild, restore, revive, God is moving. Here at Fullerton Campus, we are experiencing packed out services. Marriages are being restored, relationships are being restored, families are being restored. People are receiving healing and breakthrough. God is doing a great work, but we need more room. We are busting at the seams over here at Fullerton Campus ever since we opened the doors to allow people to come in. Our parking lot is full with people coming from all over SoCal so they can be a part of our services. Our parking lot is overflowing. And our kids church is filled to the brim with kids learning the Word of God from our awesome teachers. In our kids church, we need more space. And in this past year, we've continued to see thousands upon thousands of people come to the salvation knowledge of Jesus Christ through the preaching of His Word.
Hi, Freedom House. Pastor Brian, your Costa Mesa campus pastor. And what God has been doing in Costa Mesa has been so special. April is going to mark 2 years of our Costa Mesa campus. So hard to believe that we're already celebrating 2 years of planting our Freedom House flag, but most importantly, planting heaven in that Costa Mesa area. We've seen so much life change that has taken place. We've seen the restoration of families, the restoration of loved ones, the restoration of marriages. We're seeing children be raised up after the heart of God to do all of His will. This last pandemic year, it threw a little bit of a wrench into our plans, but our Costa Mesa campus, they stayed together. They stayed in unity. They stayed focused. We had our team members, our dream team members were serving at our emergency relief kits, at our outreach at our Fullerton campus. They were going above and beyond. They were making sure that they wanted to continue to meet the need of people. We had our worship nights that brought our campus and brought our cities and brought our region together. And we've seen people come out for our worship nights. And then we went back indoors and we've seen God continue to move. We've seen revival take place. And we had to go outdoors and we didn't know, we weren't sure how long our outdoor services were gonna last, but sure enough, they lasted a good 3.5 months. We did kids church outdoors, but we've seen God continue to move in people's lives. We've seen connect groups continue to thrive. We see Dream Team continue to thrive. Our Dream Team has gone, they've just been putting God first in so many different ways, showing up as early as 6 a.m., staying as late as 2 p.m. to see God move, to set the atmosphere of our campus so that people could come and find that much needed love of Christ that we all have needed over this last year. Even in the midst of the pandemic, we've seen people continue to go through growth track. We've seen them join the Dream Team. We're seeing baptisms take place. One story in particular, we had a lady who was baptized on her 50th birthday because she believes that revival is still going to take place in the later half of her life. And we believe that too. We know that we're seeing the rebuild, the restoration, and the revival at our Costa Mesa campus. And now we have such a great opportunity to continue to establish the kingdom of heaven, to continue to establish God's house in the Costa Mesa region so that more families, more marriages, more children, more young people can come to know Christ, can be raised up after the heart of God to do all of His will. We have church members that are going to be celebrating 2 years of sobriety. They're going to be celebrating 2 years depression-free, 2 years of debt-free, 2 years of anxiety-free because of our Costa Mesa campus. And that is all because of the generous hearts that is known as Freedom House. Because of all of you, because you gave towards the vision, because you gave towards seeing Freedom House be established in multiple campuses, you are all a part of every single one of those testimonies. You're a part of every single one of those freedoms. You're a part of every single one of those success stories. And so we thank you. And let's continue to build together. Let's continue to see God move in our Costa Mesa region, continue to establish marriages, establish families, raise up the next generation, and see God do what we've never seen Him do before.
Hey, Freedom House family, Pastor Tom here, the student and young adult pastor, and I help oversee our community outreach department. And man, I just want to report what God has been doing specifically within our community outreach and our student and young adult ministry known as Alive. In our community outreach department, I want to report to you that in the midst of the entire world shutting down, Freedom House Church, under the leadership of Pastor Sia and Pastor Marie, decided that we're going to be here to feed our community. We're going to be here to give hope to our community, to pray for families, to lead them to Christ. And I want to report to you is that as so many things began to close down, we had one of our greatest years in community outreach specifically. Last year, we did, starting in March, what we called our emergency relief kit, which consisted of hygiene packets from hand sanitizer to toilet paper to perishable goods, non-perishable goods, disinfectant soaps, all the things you weren't able to find in the grocery stores last year. We were able to connect with the resource to help us bring these back into our community. And our report to you is not just the number that we gave out that's important, but it's a matter of the families that we reached, that we provided, and just saying, there is still hope in this world. We gave over 20,000 20,000, you heard me correct, over 20,000 emergency relief kits consisting of toilet paper, bread, non-perishable goods, disinfectant soaps, hand sanitizer, sanitizing wipes, all of the good things last year that we couldn't find in the stores. Freedom House Church was the beacon of hope. But here's the best part. Because it's not just simply about what we gave out to them, it's about what we also extended to them. And that was receiving Jesus as their personal Lord and Savior. I want to report that last year, in just a matter of 6 to 7 months, we saw at our Fullerton campus, through our emergency relief kit giveaway, over 3,000 salvations. You heard me right. 3,000 salvations in our driveway, in the driveway, while things were closing down. Families were being restored. While things were starting to wreak chaos in our world, people were having encounters in the driveway of our Fullerton campus here, being prayed for. By every emergency relief kit we gave them, we also prayed for them as well as leading them and having them receive Jesus as their personal Lord and Savior. Come on, that is something to be excited about. But not only with just our emergency relief kits, with also our what we call our Feed the Need initiative, we gave out over 1,000 ready pre-cooked meals as well as 100 pre-packaged Thanksgiving meals to families within our community. But I want to report this one as well too. As many of you know, we do what we call our Adopt a Home initiative. And this year we set out a lofty goal of saying, okay, we're going to try and reach 500 families. This last year in 2020, we want to report that we reached 550 families with a pre-lit Christmas tree, toys for every single one of the children, ornaments, but groceries as well too, and praying for every single family as they came to our Fullerton campus to pick up all the essentials for their children so that they can have a Christmas for their family this year. But here's the best part as well as this too, is we prayed for every single family. So we weren't just giving them essential goods, but we were also providing a spiritual need to them as well too. So many families in tears, breakdown, writing letters to us saying, Freedom House Church, thank you for not closing, but thank you for still being a church that will pray for people, that will be the hope in our community. And I want to report to you that that was all by the vision and leadership of our lead pastors, Pastor Sai and Pastor Maria as well too. This past year for Christmas time, we reached over 2,500 children that we gave toys to every single one of them this past Christmas season. What God has been doing within our community outreach department specifically is nothing short than a miracle and nothing short of amazing. And I want to transition and head into our student and young adult ministry known as Alive Students and Young Adults. And my wife and I, we have the honor of leading this generation. And suicide rates are up higher than ever they are before. Depression, anxiety, isolation. And what 2020 did was it really withdrew a community from students. It really pulled a lot of things out of them. And so we were seeing, you know, just students reaching out to us, young adults reaching out to us with actual suicide ideation, meaning that they already thought and were having a plan on how they wanted to take their own life. And what we've been able to do is not only keep them in community, but we've been able to just be there to have authentic conversations with them. How are you doing? How's school going? We did a graduation drop-off for all those that graduated last year in 2020. We did park hangs, we did Zoom hangs, and when we came back in October for our first student young adult service, we saw students more hungry for the presence of God above anything else. And I want to report to you what God has been doing is lately we have been seeing our junior high and high school nights, known as Alive Nights, students at the end of service, service is already over, altar call already happened, but still at the altar having an encounter with God because of the deep healing that He's doing in their lives. And not only just with that, but with our young adult ministry as well, known as YA gatherings, where young adults between the ages of 18 to 30 are coming and having an authentic encounter with God. We're seeing people saying, I'm done with drugs. We're seeing young adults saying, I'm done with promiscuity. I'm done hooking up. I'm done with all this. I just want all that God has for me in my life. And this, it is nothing short of a miracle of what God is doing in our community outreach department, as well as our student and young adult department as well too, known as Alive Student Young Adult Ministry. Freedom House Church, thank you. Because of your generosity, because of your hearts to see this next generation be raised up after the heart of God, we are seeing God do tremendous things in our outreach, but also our student and young adult ministry.
Amazing testimonies. Again, the hand of God is moving, and all this is possible because of your generous hearts and people like you who are willing to say, God, you can use my life. And I want to thank you for your generosity. I want to thank you for your servant heart, because together, nothing is impossible.
Amen. You know, I want to echo that. Thank you for your generous obedience. And I say generous obedience because it comes with what you give and what you sow into this house. And you know, I reflect on the story when in the Bible where Jesus, you know, the little boy had just a few fish and just a few loaves of bread, and he gave it to Jesus. And what did Jesus do? He multiplied
right.
it. But it wasn't possible until it transferred from the hands of Amen. The boy to the hands of Jesus. And I just love what God has been doing through our generosity, through this church, through your heart yeah. as well. Just your obedience and saying, God, I'm going to put it in your hands yeah. and seeing how he multiplies it. And he just doesn't multiply the same thing over and over. He multiplies it in ways that we can't even describe, that we know that we need and that we're asking him for, but we don't even know how to put it into words. That's how God multiplies, and he just continues to multiply. When we continue to multiply in our generosity, he is faithful to multiply into things that we can't give ourselves. Only he can give it to us. So I just want to give a huge thank you for giving so generously to the mission, vision, and purpose of this house. I know that God's going to multiply once you continue to walk in that obedience and that faith and that generosity. We love you so much. We love your family. We yeah. love what God's doing in your life. And we're just so blessed to partner with you in what yeah. is yet to come.
Thank you for being on this journey to bring Jesus to this generation. It's through your generosity, our generosity, that we can truly change the world. And it's not only about legacy here on earth, but legacy for eternity, of what we will be remembered by on earth, but also would God remember us for all of eternity. Because it's one thing to attend church, but it's a whole nother thing to build a church, to say, God, I'm laying down my life to see the greatest thing on planet earth be established, God's church. Because the church is the hope of the world. The Bible says that Jesus tells us that he is building his church. And when we get behind the church, that's what Jesus is building. And you know, as I look to the future of what God's going to do, and I think about our heart for the house, which happens once a year, where we come together for the giving to empower and expand God's kingdom, I think about where we're going next and what God wants to do, even in the midst of all that has taken place. I believe the church is now more essential than ever. And I think about the future. I look at our Fullerton campus and I think about how even after the pandemic, we've come back, and it almost, you would think that because of a pandemic, it would stop the move of God. Well, listen, no pandemic is stronger than God's purposes, because now the church is full again after the pandemic. Our 9:30, 11:30, our 5 p.m., our first Wednesdays are packed out. The parking lot is full. The kids' church are full. We're having to check in kids outside. The growth track is still growing. Our Bible college, people are online, but also in the room. We're trying to fit over 100 students in our Bible college. We turn over our Freedom Kids room to be a Bible college, then we turn it back, and we still, during our outreach, we gave more to our outreach than ever before. God is moving, and we're out of space. We are completely out of space at our Fullerton campus, not to mention our kids' church. Again, I know that inside the auditorium might see a little more space, but that's not true in our kids' church as well as our parking lot. And I know that, as we mentioned last year, is we are looking, as we look to the future, to get a brand new facility, a much bigger facility for our Fullerton campus. Come on, somebody. Yeah. Where we can begin now to have rooms for all our Bible college and even our buddies' classrooms, where one of our Freedom House buddies is our special needs kids. We want them to have their own space. So I want to show you the building that we had talked about last year, this year. Here it goes. Ready? Drum roll, please. Bam. Here it is. Remember that? Look at that parking. Come on. Let's give me a better amen, because we need parking. Come on. We'd have to park down the street. You know, also look at our kids' space, and then look at the lobby area. Look at the kids' playground that we want to have, our Bible college classrooms, where we want to have room for our Bible college, where we're training future biblical leaders to step in this generation. We also want to have, you know, a playground in areas where we have vision to open up a Freedom House preschool academy, where kids can come and they can learn God's principles as they're being raised. And we want to have a room for our special needs ministry, where it's such an important ministry. We have families coming saying that they have no other church to go to because they don't have those programs, but Freedom House, we have that. And then look at all that God's going to do. Our growth track classrooms are right now, we're having to do our growth track outside, but we want to do it inside. What do we do when it's raining and all that? So that's what we want to do. Come on, give God a praise. Come on, somebody.
Yeah.
Now, I know what you're thinking. Why would we do this after a pandemic? Why would we do this now? And I'm going to tell you why. Because last year when we released this vision, the the pandemic hit, and what might have seemed like a problem, a letdown, I believe was a setup, because now buildings are more affordable than before. There is so many opportunities, guys. Listen, now is the opportunity where these warehouses are empty, these past companies that have shut down, and they are actually giving these buildings where we have an opportunity to get in ones, and there's opportunities right now. And so I wanna fire us back up that I believe that if we can come together, we can make this happen. All of us doing our part, sowing through our heart for the house and giving. And so what we're doing is we're gonna come together for that first initiative. And then there's a second initiative. I know you think I'm crazy, but I know that God can do something great when we come together. And the second initiative is this, is we've learned that when we are portable campus, we're vulnerable. And our Costa Mesa campus had to shut down for a moment. Now we're great. We love being set up in Terra, and I believe that's a great model to start with. But now Costa Mesa is going to be celebrating their 2-year anniversary. So what we're also looking to do, which that's amazing, is we're looking to get Costa Mesa their own facility as well. There's opportunities out there. And I know that if we can come together, come on Costa Mesa, we gotta get your own building, and it's been its own location. Yes. No more setup and tear down. It's a place in Costa Mesa, Freedom House, where we can begin to build and grow and have a place to call home in Jesus' name. And then our future campuses, we'll give them the trailer. We'll look to open more campuses as they begin to grow, but we wanna get Costa Mesa. So those are our two initiatives through this Heart for the House for us to come together. What do you think, honey?
Oh, it's just so exciting. There's just so much to look forward to, so much to press into, so much to pray for, so much to sow into. The future looks bright, and you know, I just love that we're building for the future. So when I think about the future, I think about our kids, all of our children. I think about our grandchildren. I think about legacy. I think about how they're able to stand on our shoulders, and they're able to leap from a place of strength and stability. And I'm so glad that we can provide that right now. We can build those things for the future, continuing to take territory and territory and territory. That's what it's about.
Absolutely. And then so if we look to a bigger location for our central campus, what we want to do out of this, have multi office space for all of our campuses, as well as be a place for our conferences where we don't have to rent out a bunch of places. Women's conference, y'all know we pack it out. Freedom House conference, we pack it out. Yeah. We want to have our own location. We don't have to rent out other places. We can have it there and see lives be changed and continue the mission where God is doing. So how are we going to do it? Here's how. It's through our Heart for the House. What is our Heart for the House? It's our once a year miracle offering where we all come together and give above our regular tithe, a sacrificial offering specifically towards empowering and expanding God's house here on earth. The verse Exodus 35:5, where the Bible says, take a sacred offering and let all those with a generous heart present their gifts for the building of God's house. And what we're doing is biblical. So I'm asking all of our church family to prayerfully consider and prepare them and ask yourself, I'm asking all of our church to prayerfully consider and prepare to give a one-time offering or a 9-month commitment on April 25th at all of our campuses. Will be a sacred day where we will come together and give a sacrificial offering to build God's house. When you walked in, they gave you a brochure. Take some time to pray through that, read through that, and you do what God calls you to do. It's not equal amounts, it's equal sacrifice. And I want all of us, every one of us can participate at some level and give sacrificially to see God's house be established. And I'm just gonna say this, I believe the pandemic has showed us that the church is more important now than ever before. And had we not had our own facility in Fullerton, we all would have been shut down, but we were still able to do ministry. We're still able to change lives because of your generosity. And I can't wait to see the great revival that's already here and is about to come. So let's partner together and remember, nothing is impossible with God. And together we can change this world one life at a time. Love you.